Hello, good morning students. Today we'll have some insight about Project Tiger. Project Tiger is a wildlife conservation movement initiated in 72 and started in 1973 with 9 tiger reserves. The project aims at tiger conservation in specially constituted tiger reserves represented of various regions throughout the India. Initially, 9 tiger reserves, that is Bandipur, Corbett National Park, Kanha, Manas, Sundarbans, Malghat, Ranthambore, Palmu and Simply Pal. These are the 9 tiger reserves which were chosen in 1973 to start with the Project Tiger. It covers the area of 9,115 square kilometers. Later on, the number it goes on increasing. In 2008, there were more than 40 Project Tiger reserves in India, covering an area of 37,761 kilometers square. And finally, in 2020, we have around 50 national parks and sanctuaries as tiger reserves, covering the area of 72,749 square kilometers to conserve the population of Royal Bengal tiger. So, 50 tiger reserves they are there in 2020. This is the location where these tiger reserves they are present. So you are going to learn at least 10 to 15 of them and demarcate on the map. For example, Corbett National Park, Sariska National Park, Ranthambore National Park, Satpura National Park, Birch National Park, Malghat National Park, Kanha National Park, then Manas National Park, Baksa National Park, then Dampa National Park, Sundarbans, Simply Pal National Park, Indravati National Park, Madhumalai National Park, Parihar National Park. So these are some of the important national parks which you are going to demarcate on the map. So being the national animal of India, the tiger, it is our duty that we have to safeguard the wildlife properly so that we can conserve the tiger. So there should be not cutting off any trees. We should protect our wildlife so that the tiger can thrive in the jungles. In 19th century, it was estimated that the tiger population in India was over 45,000. First ever survey of tiger census, which was conducted in 1972, it says that only in India 1827 tigers they were present. It is because of this reason in 1973 the Project Tiger was launched based on core buffer strategy. More than 9700 cameras took photos of Indian tigers which have been threatened by poaching and habitat loss. In 2008, the total tiger population was 1411 only. In 2014 census, it shows the tiger population as 2226, which increased from 1706 in 2010. Since then, the government has pledged $153 million to further fund the project and set up tiger protection force to combat poachers and fund for relocation of up to 2 lakh villagers to minimize human-tiger interaction. So recent data, it says, according to IUCN Red List, it is an endangered animal. In sight, it is included in Schedule 1. No international trade is permissible. According to the recent data released by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on July 29, 2019, India's tiger population has risen to 2,967 in 2018, within a span of 12 years. As per the latest data, the largest survey conducted by the government to map the tiger population in India till date was over 381,400 kilometers of forested habitat across 20 states. So, total now the population is 2,967, according to 2018 survey. So, various challenges they are there in Project Tiger. First main challenges is it is difficult to take off the land that was used for hunting earlier from the people. Second major challenge was the poaching, because the bones and skin sell to a huge margin in international market, and they earn good money. Third, during the building of sanctuaries and reserves, the human population living over there faced the problems. Therefore, they raise their voice against it, and their relocation, it is the major concern in Project Tiger. So, major threat to the tiger population. Number one, man-animal conflict. Due to anthropogenic activities, the tiger population has lost its habitat. The loss of habitat resulted in the reduction of their prey species. They started coming out of the forest and come to the villages in search of prey. Tiger, those who came in search of its prey, they are attacked. They attack the domestic animals and human beings, and ultimately they are killed by the human beings. Second, hunting, illegal trades and poaching. Hunting of tiger is a huge issue faced by the tiger population from ancient times. Hunting stands as a symbol of status. People use the bones, teeth of the tiger for commercial purposes, which can also be named as illegal trade. The body parts are used for medicinal purposes in China. Anthropogenic activities. The anthropogenic destructive activities have caused the devastation of habitat and prey species. This is the main long-term threats to the continuation of declining tiger population in the country. The man has acquired the forest land to human settlement and industrial activity. This has ultimately resulted in complete destruction of animal habitats. Future plans. The important elements in wildlife protection and control are mapping or plotting the relative spatial abundance of wild animals, identification of risk factor, proximity to the risk factor, sensitivity categorization, crime mapping, immediate action for apprehending the offenders based on effective networking and communication. Space technology has shown the interconnectivity of natural and anthropogenic phenomena occurring wherever, anywhere on the earth. Several tiger reserves are being linked with the Project Tiger Directorate in GIS domain for wildlife crime and risk management. A Tiger Atlas of India and Tiger Habitat and Population Evaluation System for the country is being developed using state-of-the-art technology involving mapping, data acquisition and GIS modeling, field data collection and validation, data maintenance, dissemination and use. So, tiger reserve are divided into two invasive region, core and buffer region. The core region should be free from any human disturbance, and the buffer region allows the minimum invasion by tribals who live around the forest, and also provided a supplementary area for wild animals to spill over. 13 breeding females need 10 males to form a viable population. The tiger is in reproductive phase of 5 years out of its average lifespan of 10 years. The management plans are drawn up for each tiger reserve. Number 1, elimination of all forms of human exploitation and biotic disturbance from the core area, and rationalization of activity in the buffer regions. Number 2, restriction of habitat management only to repair the damage done to the ecosystem by human and other interferences so that to facilitate recovery of ecosystem to its natural state. Number 3, monitoring of faunal and floral changes over time and carrying out research about the wildlife. So, is it too late? The National Tiger Conservation Authority, NTCA, in collaboration with state forest departments, conservation NGOs and coordinated by Wildlife Institute of India, has been conducting a national assessment for status of tiger, co-predator, prey and their habitat every 4 years since 2006. Tiger occupancy has increased in the state of Madhya Pradesh, which ranks highest in tiger population along with Karnataka. Tiger status in the states of Chhattisgarh and Orissa is poor and continue to decline. First white tiger sanctuary in Madhya Pradesh was inaugurated in 2016. So, Bagh Bachao, Jungle Bachao, Bharat Bachao is a rallying cry of tiger NGOs. All a tiger needs is little bit of cover, some water and some prey. So, we have to conserve the tiger. If we conserve the tiger, then only we can protect our jungles. If we protect our jungle, then only clean air, clean water and good climate will be available for our future generation. Thank you.